portfolio on builders. Before we are going to discuss about this rectifier and filter, we have to know about the two different types of currents that are present in our diameter. First one is the AC current. Whenever you want to draw this AC current, we are indicating AC current is like this. Why? It is having the values in the positive half cycle, or when it is having the values in the negative half cycle. So that is a continuous current or a alternating current, you can call that as. Okay, coming to the, if you want to represent the DC signal, you will be representing the like this. This is the trend signal. Okay. Here, if you are observing here, this signal is not having the values in the negative side. Here it is it is having the values in the positive half cycle and the negative half cycle. So you are converting this coming to the DC signal, it is having only in the positive half cycle. This bilateral signal is converted into the unidirectional signal. That is nothing but the DC signal. By using rectifiers, we are converting this alternating current to the unidirectional current, IDC signal. So that why you need to convert this alternating current to the DC signal is most of the electronic devices, like if you want to charge your battery, you should use an adapter. That adapter is using a DC signal. So whatever input you are getting from the transformer, that is an AC signal, that is also converted to the DC signal by using the rectifiers. And if you want to charge your laptop, in that situation also you are using the DC signal. So by using rectifiers in the electronic devices, this alternating current will be converted into the pulsating DC signal. Whatever voltage, this is unregulated, and then it will be given to the filter. After when output of the rectifier will be given to the filter, when it is given to the filter, filter will be giving the regulated pure DC. Will be giving us the QDC. So these rectifiers are divided into, basically these rectifiers are divided into two types: half-wave rectifier and full-wave rectifier. Coming to the half-wave rectifier again, with filter.
Transformers are mainly divided into two types: step down transformer or a step
step up transformer. Here I am using a step down transformer. Depending on the transformer I am using, here we are getting a either 9 volts or 12 volts signal. That signal, that voltage will be getting at the output of the transformer. When the positive off cycle is given to the diode, here positive is given, positive off cycle of this AC signal is given to the diode. Here it is not. Diode is having two terminals. First one is the anode and the second one is the, here it is the cathode. When positive is given to the positive of the diode, then the diode will be short circuited. So the output will be appears across the RL. Load resistor, you are getting the whatever input you are applying at the transformer, that output will be appearing at the load resistor RL. Okay, this is about the applying, when we are applying the positive off cycle to the positive of the diode. If you are applying a negative off cycle to the here it is a diode. Now I am applying a negative off cycle to the diode. Then I am applying a negative to the positive. Here it is the positive of the diode. And this is the negative of the diode. Negative is applied to the positive of the diode. So when negative is applied to the positive of the diode, then it will be reverse bias. During reverse bias condition, diode will be open circuit. So during reverse bias, diode will be open circuit. So from the load you are not getting any output. So this is waveform for the off way rectifier. This is the tantalum, this is the voltage, initially when you are applying the positive off cycle to the transformer, to the diode. During positive, diode will be short circuited, positive will be connected to the positive of the diode, then the diode will be powered by us, it will be short circuited, will be getting the output like this. When negative off cycle of the AC signal is given to the diode, negative is connected to the positive of the diode, then it is reverse bias and it is acting as a open circuit. So there is no conduction in the reverse bias condition. So you are getting the output like this. During the positive off cycle, you are getting a conduction. So you are getting output like this. And during negative off cycle, there is no conduction taking place. This is the time period. For example, if you are applying 2 VM as the input signal, here you will be getting the VM is the from here to here. This is 2 VM. 0, 5. This is the time period of that particular signal. Whatever input you are applying, that is be divided into off cycle. So you are getting only positive off cycle of the pulsating DC by using the off way rectifier. If this the output of this this is the off way rectifier without filter. When you are not using the filter in the off way rectifier circuit, you are getting the output like this. The output of a load resistor will be connected to the capacitor. If it is connected to the, this is the transformer, again it will be given to the diode, output is given to the load resistor. again it will be given to the capacitor. Here capacitor is acting like a filter in this of a rectifier. And now here we are getting the pulsating DC signal at the load resistor R after this of a rectifier operation is completed. And the output of this load resistor is given to the capacitor. You will be getting the output. This is the output of the off-air rectifier when it is connected to the load resistor. The output of the load resistor is given to the capacitor. Then the capacitor is acting like a filter. Here we are getting the pulsating DC. To get the flow DC, I am giving this load resistor output to the filter. After that, I am getting the
D1 is on, D2 will be off.
डी वन
Yeah.